So a question we get asked a lot is, well, doc, how the heck do you know an AVM is around? And the tough thing with AVMs is many times they're silent. You never know they're there, many times for years and years. The most common way we find an AVM is because a child will have symptoms. Something will happen. They may have a seizure, they may have a really bad headache. In some scary cases, the AVM might bleed, and that can lead to unconsciousness or even life-threatening problems where they get rushed into the hospital. But the way we find out that one is there is almost always an MRI or a CAT scan is done, and you see a tangle of blood vessels. Sometimes there's a blood clot around the AVM if something has happened emergently, and it's not always easy to see with the swelling and the blood that's there. So while we treat whatever we need to treat emergently, there are many times we will say, if the child is doing okay, we let things rest for several weeks, let the bruise, the blood dissolve, if we think the child is safe, and then we'll repeat the picture several weeks later, in which case, once the swelling has gone down, we can really see the anatomy a lot better. And that's important because sometimes you can miss parts of the AVM that weren't present when there was swelling that you can see later. The kind of pictures we take will include basically three things. Sometimes we'll get a CAT scan, either with or without dye, where they put a little IV in. You can get an MRI, which looks at the surrounding brain and the blood vessels. Part of an MRI study can be called an MRA, an MR angiogram, where you look at blood vessels. And the third is called a catheter angiogram, or a digital subtraction angiogram. And that's a test, again, looking at blood vessels, but the difference is many times the child is asleep, and one of the radiologists will do a little procedure where they put a little IV or a wire in a blood vessel in the hip, and then thread the wire up into the brain and take very detailed pictures, actual movies, to see the anatomy of the blood vessels. And those can be really, really helpful with AVMs. So those are generally the ways we figure out that an AVM is present and then understand the anatomy of the AVM. Once we understand what the plumbing looks like, if you will, that leads next to the discussion of sort of when and how we treat them. So we'll address that next.